Absolute Batman is two issues in, and it is still turning out to be, in my opinion, the best out of what the Absolute Universe DC is doing so far. I reviewed Absolute Superman number one and Absolute Wonder Woman number one. I wasn't impressed with them. I thought Absolute Wonder Woman was kind of boring. I mean, plus saying no different than the story. Like, I don't have a problem with the whole her being raised by Cersei. And like, I think a nice twist. I just wanted some more out of it other than that. And with Absolute Superman, that class system thing on Krypton and what it was trying to do and all of that just didn't mesh up right with me for what it was to do. Now, like I said, Absolute Batman number one had some issues that I pointed out. Yeah, and they, but overall, I thought the book came off really well. You get to issue number two as well. And again, there are some issues here and there as well. But overall, I think the story is going okay. Now, I'm not going to go through the whole thing and this and the other thing and the other stuff like that, because there are some people who haven't read it yet. I'm going to touch on the few key things that I thought were actually really interesting about it. There are going to be some spoilers here, but mostly it's stuff that could work with going forward. Now, the thing about this is that it is still being told mostly from Alfred's perspective. He's a government secret agent, we want to call him, in Gotham, and he is dealing with Batman and the whole party animals thing, and he's recording on what's going on. And one thing he has realized about Batman is that this guy does not retreat. Like, he just keeps going forward no matter what. Now, once again, Batman is taking on the party animals at this local aquarium. And his fighting style is to just brute force his way through things because he's been stabbed, they shot him, all kind of thing. And again, he is using his cape for pretty much everything. Got that cape like a friggin' Swiss Army knife on his back, to be honest with you. Is he even a point in the book where he's using the cape to rappel down a building and climb? I'm like, just give the guy a grappling hook now. Come on. Yeah, it does kind of bother me with this cape thing. Like I say, he doesn't have the money. He's not supposed to have the money, but he has access to all these different gadgets. I mean, it's the one thing, I've been wondering if the cape could have just fly, but the cape could hook people, you could walk on it with like tentacle arms, like Dr. Octopus, all kind of thing. It's really just kind of disturbing. But he is fighting the party animals, and like I said, he has like he has knives sticking out of him. He's got a ninja star in his head, and he's still going. And Alfred is thinking to himself, you know, this guy is outnumbered. He needs to retreat. He needs to pull back because this is really crazy. And again, I don't know where all these party animals coming from. Because like, you have like a whole bunch of people in Gotham with nothing better to do with their lives to do this. But as they rush Batman and look to just take him out, turns out everything he's doing is part of his plan. He intentionally got himself lured into that position so he could rupture the fish tank to the back of him. And when the water spreads there and everything, you know, he again uses his cape, which is like a Swiss Army knife, to latch onto things, and he's up above the water. And they're like, yeah, well, we're going to get you now. We can't do anything. But then he takes out this small pill, I think you could call it, and basically, when you throw, it's a chemical, when you throw vinegar into salt water, it turns into high hydrochloric acid. So he literally just burns their freaking limbs off. Honestly, see men running outside there, please, and burn the next one, cousin toes are gone. And this is what's going on because you're literally using that. Literally kill these people, like I'm saying, because he blew up some of them last time. Now he's melting their limbs off and all of that. It is bloody funny to watch. And you also get to find out, as Alfred is checking in on him, that Batman has a bunch of different, I guess you could call them, like, caves or points all over the city. And he's made out so many that it actually shapes into a bat symbol across the city. And during the day, he just does what he has to do and all of that. But Alfred was actually also trying to keep the location of Batman's lairs or caves, if you want to call them, away from the party animals being able to detect it. He was trying to protect him doing that, but his handler told him, he needs to stop all protections for Batman and all of that, so he has to drop it. And the party animals find out where one of Batman's location is in these high-rise buildings, because apparently there are a lot of buildings and unused stuff all over Gotham that nobody ever goes into. Like, they just build them and leave them there. And they go there looking to just off him. And that day, working with Batman, just blows the whole damn thing up. I tell you, again, they're trying to make it seem like them are out there, but some of them had to die. Literally, some of them had to die. So he blows the thing up and makes it look like an actual bat face thing there, that he is just going forward. Because, like Alfred said, he's just one long advance forward, or Batman AF, as he calls it. So this is what's going on. We do get to see Jim Gordon in the hospital there with his daughter and Bullock and stuff. And for some reason, I don't know, now Jim Gordon is looking quite black. He look a little bit like he more tanned than black before. And you could see he have a US Marine Corps tattoo on. So he was there and stuff with it. And then we have Martha Wayne shows up. She comes in there to check on him and stuff. And the others leave, and they talk in there. And Martha lights up a cigarette.
Oh, I'd give anything for a drag. Just one drag.
I just had to put in that thing with the scene from Ghost and the drag. I was just so bloody sick. We had to play that. And then, Martha and Jim get to talking about it and all sort of stuff. And, she asks, Jim asks, how is Bruce? And she says that before that day, he was my little boy. He told me everything, every dumb detail of his day, his whole inner life was mine to know. But now I barely know him at all, and all of this stuff there. You get to find out that he was very, after his father died, he was very depressed and thing, and he yelled at his mother and all kind of thing and stuff like that. And this kind of throws it in the face of all the people who were like that same stupid article from Screen Rant about how Martha Wayne in his life now is a big difference. Like, I think he's still basically Batman. He lost his father, he still went down that road of despair and all of that stuff like that, And she announces that she barely even knows him anymore. She barely knows him. So apart from being freaking huge, there ain't much else to him. Then you have Batman, Bruce Wayne goes to see his friends to have a game of poker. We have guy who's Killer Croc, we have guy who's Riddler, guy who's Penguin, all sort of stuff like that. And the thing about it is that you have Bruce Wayne doing the same thing he normally does. He goes to see his friends and them there, and he's basically just, he's playing cards with them, basically using it as an excuse to get information out of them. Because, some of his friends, like guy who's Riddler and Penguin and stuff, are in some kind of illegal activities and stuff. And he's just trying to get information out of them. Kind of a dick move, since you haven't seen your friends before, but it's Batman. It's kind of what goes on. That was the thing I didn't really dig in this comic with him doing that, but it is what it is, you understand me? That's what he was doing to try and get the information out of them. And once he does that, then now he finds out that, there's something going on with Mayor Hill, goes to his office, and all of that. And then all of a sudden, the guy who's running the whole party animal thing comes up on the screen and tells him, this is one big trap. They've alerted the police to where he is. They're going to get him. And then you have one of the party animals fire an RPG that just blows stuff up, but that doesn't kill him. Because, you know, again, that cape is like a Swiss Army knife for everything. So he uses the cape to open up a thing, and he goes down there and he encounters Alfred, who's there, and he tells him that, you know, he's a good detective, but he's here to help him, and you know, he doesn't know anything about the party animals, and he says that, you know, he could assist him with certain stuff, and he tells him, all right, so Batman tells him he'll give him 30 seconds, and he's like, all right, thank you, but we need to get out of here. They're all over the place. We have to get somewhere safe. I have a car hidden out back, unless you have one. And then Batman is just revving it up, and you're standing in it. See, Alfred, this. Why, you're like, holy shit. And Batman with this look on his face, he's just grinning there, and Alfred is like, actually, Alfred's face in this thing is what gets me. And then you see the Batmobile come glaring out. It's the last page of the comic, and the Batmobile has come blaring out there, taking out police cars and all kind of stuff like that. I mean, I will say before I say again, I still think it looks too big and ridiculous, but the way they do this, I must admit, it actually did play out really good, and I did enjoy it. So overall, my rating for Absolute Batman number 2, I will give it a 4 out of 5. I think overall the story hasn't been bad. The things are moving along at a nice pace. You know, the stuff is good. Alfred's face at the end there was really spectacular. Batman with his huge Batmobile come blaring out at him. But honestly, had they played this song when Batman came blaring out at him with that Batmobile, this would have cinched it for me. So yeah, I'm just going to leave this out with this song playing for you all. Take care.